Job description. As soon as we hear this word, what do we make of it? How many times we have gone back to job description and actually started working towards our interview process? Well, 9 out of 10 times students or job aspirants fail to approach this particular process because they fail to understand the seriousness of job description. Nowadays, there are softwares of many companies operational in many areas, and what they check when they advertise job description and seek resumes or CV in return is basically the keywords. So whatever that job description has been advertised or put to an advertisement, or a job description has been defined, why it is defined and is always forwarded to the candidates? Because it has a meaning. It gives the clarity of what profile they are looking candidate to be recruited, what material they should possess, what are the skill sets that they should have, both hard and soft skills. In case if there is an experience sought, then which specific area they are asking to have an experience or exposure to. And most importantly, all the keywords are basically the buzzwords or the power words, which are the underlining words which should be necessarily get featured in the resume. One, second, also be consistently exhibited in the interview. And third is, they should also be keen to give an example so that there is a good understanding of that candidate in terms of possessing those skills which are mentioned in the job description, and which helps the HR or the recruiter or an employer to recruit, to hire such a material. So job description is not mere an advertisement. It's just not a document which stands in isolation. Instead, job description is one such document, a foolproof document which bridges the right candidate to the right company. So if you have already determined few dream jobs and few dream companies of yours which you'd like to work with, try and initiate job description. Try and understand what job description is. So today's this particular shoot, we are going to cover job description. A job description is a document intended to provide job applicants with an outline of the main duties and responsibilities of the role for which they are applying. This we have understood. The description is usually drawn up by the individual in the organization responsible for overseeing the selection process for the role, often with the help of company's HR department or an external recruiter, which we all know as job consultant. So why is the job description important at all? As I've mentioned earlier, let's get into the detail of it. A job description is an essential part of the job application process, as with the right information, it should help applicants to determine whether the role is in line with their skill sets and whether it is a job they actually want to do. From the organization's perspective, the job description is vital in ensuring that the applications receive for the position closely match the needs of the role itself. It helps HR departments and external job consultants to streamline the selection process and receive a high concentration of candidates who are suitable for interview or further selection. So, a job description helps to streamline the hiring process. So, what are the main uses of job description? There are many benefits to an effective job description. Here are just some of its key uses, and they are: to provide the employee with the expectations that are required of them in the role, to provide enough detail to help the candidate assess if they are suitable for the position or not, to support the recruitment team during the selection process, to help formulate questions for the interview process, to allow the prospective employee to determine their role or standing within the structure of the organization, to assist in forming a legal binding contract of employment, to help set goals and target for the employee upon joining to aid in the evaluation of the employee's job performance, to help formulate training and development plans. So this is an exhaustive way of understanding why a job description and how it is interpreted by the company or an organization that you are applying for. So what is typically included in a job description? Let's get into this. A well-rounded job description should clearly identify the purpose of the role as well as the key tasks to be performed and the main accountabilities of the position. The document will usually also include a brief background and overview of the organization, as well as the name or position of the employee the successful candidate will be reporting to. In addition, you can also expect to find an explanation of the kind of candidate the organization is looking for. This might include their professional experience and achievements, skill sets, educational background, qualification, as well as any desired personality traits in specific. The description will also include practical information such as where the job is based, the location, whether it's full or part-time, nature of the job, the scale and scope of the job, and in most cases, the intended salary, remuneration. The key points that would normally be included in a job description entails title and summary of the role, list of duties, desired professional experience, education level and desired qualifications, core skills required for the position, necessary certificates, licenses and registrations, who the prospective employee will directly report to, whether the employee has any subordinates reporting to them, physical requirements if needed, work environment, employment conditions, etc., etc. What is the typical structure of a job description? A job description should follow a simply laid out, accurate format that clearly defines the needs of the role. While the actual structure will typically vary between roles and organizations, a well-rounded job description will normally be loosely structured as follows. One could be job title, the position, designation. Second would be location, which location they are looking for. Bangalore, Hyderabad, Mumbai, Pune, Gurgaon, or Delhi, or Kolkata, any place for that matter. Reports to the immediate boss that this candidate will be reporting to. Job purpose, a brief line or two as to what is the purpose, the scale and scope of that particular job. Duties and responsibilities will be in detail where this candidate will be performing in the day-to-day routine. Essential and desirable criteria. So what is that specific qualification? What is that specific experience? Or what is that specific technical skill or qualification being asked for, so that it becomes an ideal for the recruiter to map it with their job description and immediately shortlist that candidate. Company or team overview. And the eighth is application information. So these are a kind of a rough outline of what the typical structure of job description looks like. Now let's come to what are the limitations of a job description. So job description also have some or the other kind of limitations. It can be very difficult to capture what a job will really entail within a few short paragraphs. Furthermore, some positions within an organization may be newly created roles, and when creating the job description, it may not always be possible to fully foresee the way the role will develop and be adapted over time. So after having gone through a complete understanding of job description, now there are two sides of the coin. One is the job description gets floated in form of an advertisement and it reaches the right campuses, colleges, job consultants or the online job portals, wherever they come from, but eventually they land up to a job aspirant. And thus it becomes the other side of the coin to be counterbalanced with the candidate's understanding of the job description, understanding of what kind of skill sets are desired by that particular candidate to fill in that form or an application and move further. So ideally, the job description is a clear ask of what the company wants from the candidate, and the candidate should be good enough, clever enough, intelligent enough to interpret it the right way and start building their resume in the direction of the specified job description. So I hope by understanding job description, what we have tried to give you all is an overall perspective, the 360 degree angle that job description means and how it is to be prepared, interpreted and exhibited consistently so that you are taking the full control of the interview process and justify your inclusion working with your dream company. I hope this would make a lot of sense to all the job seekers of any industry that they are wanting to work with. Here's wishing you all best luck. Thank you.